I be so sick of you niggas, y'all contradicting. I be so bored with myself and you come and fuck me. I feel so ordinary, stepping you around me. Treat me like gold, like you carry on. Arguments, you carry me on. Tripping about your whereabouts. I can't keep no conflict with you, boy, can we just rub it out? I don't want no static with you, you know you my thug. And I can't shake this tab enough. Anyway, my hair is nappy. I took it down yesterday from my little style I had from the last vlog. Y'all, I'm so over it. I just got off work. Today started to feel drowsy. Like, I think because I didn't really just eat all my lunch. I played over it. That's the meal y'all seen. And this is probably going to be like a weekly / weekend vlog, I guess. I don't know. But yeah. So, this is my good news. Hopefully, I don't forget to put this in the title. My good news is your girl is done with her book. Finally. First part. Yay! I'm finally done with the first part of my book, y'all. And I was so excited until I started going online and looking up all the things that I still have to do before putting it out there. And I need to change this shirt because this shirt is not going to work for avoiding bugs. I don't know. I might keep it on. I don't know. But, yeah, I was about to go work out. I'm about to go work out. But I just wanted to come check in with y'all and tell y'all this. Good news. So, it's good news. I was extremely excited. Until I seen all the stuff I gotta pay for before even putting it out there. So now I'm sitting here trying to see what the fuck I wanna do. Cause I said I wanna put it out by July. I'd be so glad when my neck clears up. I don't know what the fuck it's doing, what it's going through. I don't know. But I don't know. But anyway, I was so excited until I saw all the stuff that I still have left to do. Well, stuff I have to purchase. I didn't know it was so complicated. This is not my first time putting out a book, but this is my first official book. Like, this is my first book that I went through the full process for. Well, I'm going through the full process for. Like, I went to school. I wrote it. I had help with it. Through a professional editor. And then now I'm going through the process of getting the ISBN, barcodes, things like that. So, yeah, this is one of those. So, I look so big. Like, this, anyway. Yeah, this is a little complicated for me with just some stuff I saw. I was looking Bro, because I want to make sure, like, the copyrights website is so specific. Like, I don't know. Like, I want to make sure I have everything. So I'm still not done. I got to do some more shit. Like, I got to reach back out to the person that actually designed my cover. I got to purchase an ISBN, probably a barcode as well. I don't know if I'm supposed to do those before I purchase copyrights. I don't know. So I got to settle down and do that because I wanna go ahead on and start the process before this week is over with, so that I can get confirmation back how I need to before I even like print my books and stuff like that. But I don't even know. I still gotta look into that because I saw where some processes take long as fuck. So I don't know. But anyway, so welcome to another vlog. Welcome back. Thank y'all for coming back in. You know, again, stay tuned for what more I have coming in this video. If you are liking thus far what you see, or if you haven't checked out any of what I have on my channel, make sure you go check it out so you can see more of like my vibe, more of what I do. And if you like it, subscribe and like, comment. Shout me out, whatever. But if you don't, it's okay. It's plenty of other YouTubers on the platform that also post great content. But yeah, so stay tuned, y'all. I'm back. Probably another day. Y'all know I slept good and I'm feeling good. Okay. I mean, as soon as it's smiling. Do I like the taste of it? Hell no. I tasted when I was pouring it. But it's not a rule to, it's not a bad taste. So it's eatable. And I'm glad I made it this morning, y'all, because my psycho is on. And basically, when I do my research, like on Google and stuff, basically tells, oh my God. It basically tells us that you're supposed to be eating healthy all the time, most of the time. So, on your cycle, I always try to have, like, lately though, like, it's only every once in a while I'll have a bad cycle. But lately, my cycle has been smooth. Even this time, it came on very smooth. Y'all. So, today, try to see what I want to do today.
today is kind of going to be like a gear up day for the weekend, I guess. But I do have to go. I have an appointment at 1 o'clock. Yo, I need to fix my hair. And I said I wanted to wash it and everything. But I don't know what I want to style. I don't know how I want to style it. So it's not getting washed because I don't know how I want to style it. So it's going back probably in the bun until I figure out what the fuck I want to do to it. And then I might just wash it or whatever. Oh, my God. I really just woke up like this. Happy Friday to all of y'all. And look, the lip plate just holding on for dear life. But it's there. I have to wash, too, and I kind of want to get that out the way before I go to the appointment. So, I got to go ahead on and put on me some clothes because I got to wash. But after the, I don't even know how the appointment is going to go. I'm hoping and praying that I get somewhere with it, though. But if not, I ain't tripping. I got to get my car cleaned out and everything. But, yeah, I'm just going to the appointment to kind of just let them do like a test on my car, like just let me know everything that it needs and what's really needed, if anything is any, if you know, if anything is even needed. Now I start from the bottom and work my way up. But yeah, that's all we have to do today is really, but I'm tempted. I did want to tell y'all that I'm tempted to go to the mall. Damn, my video uploaded fast. My weekend vlog that I just filmed that I'm posting, it uploaded really fast. I just, like, literally maybe 30 to 40 minutes ago, I just put it up there. I'm just not used to my videos uploading fast at all. So, but yeah. So, anyway. But, I kind of want to go to the mall. I've been looking at Steve Madden shoes. Yeah, I got this obsession for shopping. I've been looking at them shoes, and I'm obsessed. I'm really obsessed. And I'm tempted to purchase them. And they got a good deal online. Now, I don't know what they got going on in the store, but online, I think the original price is like $99.95 for the shoes. But I'm finna show them to y'all too. But but if you use a code, you'll get 30% off. Well, it'll bring the price to $70, so you'll save at least $20 to $30. But I'm in love. Like, look at these. I'm so tempted. But I was going to get these. If I don't go in the store and get them, I'm definitely going to sit here on this phone and order them offline. I was going to get these. Like, obsessed with shopping, bro. I don't know what the fucking problem is. Like, I don't be doing shit, so it's like, spend some money. You got it, spend it. So, that's what I be doing. But yeah, so, yeah, I'm tempted to go in the store because I'm trying to see if I could do the same. I mean, in the mall, because they have a Steve Madden store in the mall. And I kind of want to get them today for some reason. But if not, I'm going to get them offline. And I'm going to do Klarna and pay, like, every 2 weeks. And I'm gonna just get one pair. Like, I might get the white pair because I'm really like whatever color they are, beige, white. Even though I like the brown ones with the black and white strings, but I feel like everybody kind of like, I don't even think it really matters that everybody have them. I just don't know what I'm gonna wear with them. So I think I'll get the white ones. Like, I already kind of have outfits that I haven't even worn that I have to wear that I'm also waiting on another pair of shoes for. But if I get them, I know they'll probably beat those shoes back and I could go ahead on to wear the outfit, start wearing them. You know, I got a few outfits. But I really don't know what I'm finna do to my head, y'all. I'm just sitting here like, I'm thinking I might put just a braid in it because it's already straightened. And I just might wash it Sunday. It made it 2 weeks of me just, well, the style didn't make 2 weeks, but I haven't washed it or nothing. So I just basically brushed it into this plait and even added the same hair products onto it. But yeah, I don't want to overtalk y'all. I'm going to check back in with y'all. I'm going to let this camera charge up. And I'm going to go wash and everything, get myself together, knock that out the way. And then I'm going to the appointment. And I guess I'll check back in with y'all when I come out of the appointment. And then we'll see what we will do today. This is dedicated to all the mamas.
That's right, nigga.
Y'all, need to go to Starbucks before I go to this place. I forgot why I really came, because I'm really leaving out early, but I forgot why I really left out. Not only because of traffic, but it was because I was supposed to stop at Dollar General and give me some deodorant. My favorite spray deodorant that I'm going to show y'all, because that's officially, like, they are the Dove spray. Deodorants are officially my favorites right now. I haven't tried any other ones, but right now they are my favorites. I have to try other ones in order to know if they could be my favorites. But right now, I'm gonna show y'all when I go to Dollar General if I pass one. I'm trying to see if I'm gonna pass one on the way to the place, because I do. I try to be proud of people musty. I don't get musty like that though, but I do. I don't know why I'm telling y'all these, but I do want to put on. I gotta buy some deodorant, bro. I don't do stanky. I don't do must. I don't do it. You know, I don't. So, in case y'all thought I was lying, I'm gonna bag up. I got lucky. I thought about it. They had a seat. They got a CVS, like, right. So boom, they got a CVS that's right across the street from the Hyundai, as you can see. And I gotta hurry up and rush over there. See. Boom. So yeah, they got a Hyundai place. The Hyundai place that I'm going to is right there. Hopefully they don't be long. I really just need them to tell me what's going on with my car. They ask for them over if I fix it. Okay, we just got out. So, yeah. And this is one. Okay, yeah. This is the Dove. I can show y'all. This is the Dove. I like they Dove deodorant spray. This is one of them. I actually use different brands. But this one, I'm telling you, spray it in your... Spray it in your... If you in your room and you putting your deodorant on, this I just paid $10 for it out of here. But if I go to Dollar General or Family Dollars, I think they'd be like $1 or $2 cheaper. But I'm telling y'all, it leaves its scent. Okay, it's like a perfume. Like, don't play with it. Let me get this junk out so these people wouldn't think I'm nasty. They gonna think it anyway, because I got shit everywhere in this car. But I'm gonna put this stuff in the bag. Well, hopefully they don't throw this bag away. I'm gonna close it up. But yeah, I'm gonna go over here, just put my deodorant on. I'm gonna go over here. My appointment isn't until 1 o'clock, honestly. I'm here much, much early, but it don't look like they got much going on, so. I mean, it ain't like they fixing it. All I'm doing is pulling up and letting them see what's going on with it. So, I'm gonna go back over there in a few minutes. But yeah, I done put my deodorant on. I'm feeling good. Bitch, I be feeling good though. I feel good. I ain't even lying. My head is nappy. I don't know what I'm gonna do to it, y'all. I don't know what I'm gonna do to it. I'm thinking about just slapping a ponytail in it until Sunday night. And Sunday night after Mother's Day, I will come to the house and I will wash it then. I don't feel like washing it and waiting on it to dry, styling it this way, styling it that way. Okay. So, it is a no for me. they were very rude too. I don't know if I guess people be having so much going on, but nobody's not nobody's convincing enough when it comes to business. Like, a lot of people just automatically feel like you either should know or you don't deserve it. Like, they don't run a business like they want your business. Like, people run being working in companies and they treat you like you somebody that like need them. Like, it ain't a whole bunch of options out here. So I would not be bringing my car back to this place. For one, just for them to look at it and tell you what's going on with it, they start that off at $160. And then this guy, who was very, I can't just say he was inconsiderate, because he caught himself just writing down a bunch of things that I automate, because I don't know, maybe he do know what he's talking about, because I feel that I need these things checked. But I had my car for like three to four years. But it is a 2010, almost 3 to 4 years. It's a 2010. Whoever we bought it from did their damn thing with it, because we only had to get it checked out. I mean, get it fixed, but we paid good money just because of down here at these places like this. Like, these places overcharge you just because they know you don't want to deal with the people that could possibly fuck your shit up. Like, you be taking chances either way it go though too, because they only gonna do certain things just so you can bring it back to them and they can make more money off of you. But he wrote down these things right here and told me that, like, he was like, you just judge from the looks of the car. I'm not getting that done. That's not how that go. Like, it was very inconsiderate. I don't even want to bring my car back to them. Because, yeah, he was like, and judging from it, the miles and, you know, how long you had it, I guarantee none of these have been done twice or some shit he was saying. So basically, when you come to them, they just expected for you to get it fixed. So that's a first no-no, because how the fuck you even know if I know yours? How you know I know bad service or not? How you know I know if you don't give bad service? How you know I don't know if you have bad reviews? Why would I just bring my car to you just for you to fix it? Like, you just know what you're doing. That's a no-no. And then for two, the guy, they had put a plastic thing on the rug and a plastic bag on the seat. And he was like, oh, yes, ma'am, you can give me that if you don't plan to get it fixed. I guess the guy who fixes the car. So I said, okay. Handed him the plastic and the thing. And he was like, thank you. I said, mm-hmm. Because when he walked up, he was like, you know, hand him that and this, then the third. So I guess the way they work, like, you either just bringing it there to get it fixed or you not. And if you not, go ahead. That's it. Like, that's how they were feeling today. I don't know, y'all. I can't. This is why I just don't deal with folks. Like, people really be pissing me off. So, yeah, I would never bring my car back to them. Like, it was a... I don't even know. I just didn't pull it out, though, because I didn't think I was going to leave this fast. I didn't pull it out, but I'm trying to see what my next move is, because I don't know if I want to go inside of the mall. Or I think I'm going to just order them shoes online, and I guess I'll stop at Rainbow for something, because I need to find something for that party tomorrow. I got to go to Mississippi tomorrow hella early. I have to go view a body before a funeral. The viewing starts at 2, so I need to leave my house at 1, no later than 1, so to get there at least like right after 2, and view and come on out, you know, it's family. But yeah, that kind of ticked me off, y'all. I ain't gonna even lie to y'all. They just was very inconsiderate, you know. I don't want to deal with that type of business, you know. It's either you pull your car up here to get it fixed or you don't. They charge you an arm and a leg. Who the fuck, first and foremost, how the fuck y'all even know somebody got $160 just for y'all to pull it in y'all shop and tell them what it is? Listen at these folks. Pull it in just for them to tell you. I'm spitting everywhere. Just for them to tell you what's going on with your car, they charge you $160. It don't get any more inconsiderate than that. That pissed me off to the max, baby. Like that made me feel some type of way, for sure. $160 just for them to tell you just for them to tell you what's wrong with your car, baby, that's a light bill.
Anyway, I don't know what I'm gonna do now. That's the only Hyundai place. I mean, it don't seem like, I don't know. Like, I guess when I get $1,000 but he was nice enough to write everything down on the list. But when I get $1,000 to just give, then I'll bring my car back to them.
Y'all go tune into the channel. I'm looking at my own sheet. This vlog is actually about to go off. I just been in the play. I watched the beginning, but I had been in the play while I had went to the washer. Because I was actually expecting to go to the washer and come back here. I put this on because, baby, the hair is not giving. And guess what? We better go sit at a restaurant and catch a vibe. I just want to get out the house, but I do need to eat. I want to eat one meal. I've been kind of like snacking. I've been eating like Ruffles, my smoothie. I went to Starbucks and got a grilled cheese with a drink. But, yeah. So, yeah, it's so crazy how, okay, I'm at, was at the washateria. I was washing, so all my other two loads of clothes were dry. I just actually separated them and put them up. But once of my set of my clothes, it was like somebody opened my dryer and then started back. They didn't close it back and then started back. And you know, it pissed me off so much about that. It was only one person in there washing, so nobody else was washing. So why would, you know what I'm saying, unless they was wash when I look, but they couldn't wash that fast. I don't know, fuck that, you never know. But anyway, I come back to another girl was washing in my same washers, and she used my same dryers. So I think she was expecting, or she was going to probably take my clothes out or do something, because they were damp as hell. So it had to be somebody that come right in right after me. Like, or they had to be washing along with me. I think it was another girl washing along with me, but I don't know. Her clothes should have been already dried and everything. But I don't see no point if you weren't using the dryer. But this specific girl that was just using the same washers and dryers that I use. So I'm just looking because, bitch, you stopped my dryer. I know you did. And you didn't even have the common decency, because the way you even up in here doing your clothes now, you didn't give a fuck. You don't give a fuck about yours. Bitch, I don't want to wash either. So if you're going to stop my dryer, have common sense enough to start it back. Yes, my clothes are in there. What the hell you was going to do? Steal damn clothes or take them and throw them any kind of way? You think I wasn't going to come and check my damn dryer? I ain't like all these other people. Anyway, my dryer was stopped. So now I'm behind on a load of clothes that I'm about to go actually get, because when I left out of there, it was 5:45. I didn't section off some clothes. Put on a little bit more perfume in my hat. So I'm pretty sure they should be by, like, at least at 30 minutes by now, 30-some minutes. So it shouldn't take long for them to be close to dry, because it wasn't many in there. Like, I was so confused. It even had me thinking that they may have stole some clothes. Like, I'm like, I know it had clothes, unless I just opened the dryer and felt my clothes. So I didn't even look for what could have possibly been in there. I just felt them, and I'm like, they damp, you know. Cause I'm not gonna remember everything I put in them, you know. But I know my clothes. But like, why my dryer stopped at 60? So weird. Like, it had to be stopped, unless I don't remember starting it. I don't know. I don't even know. Cause I don't even know if I could blame somebody. But cause it was like stopped, and it was just sitting there. Usually when it be like that, I don't think that it'll stay that way. You know, like, it'll stop the transaction or start over, but it was like somebody opened it and it just automatically started over. Like, it just had been sitting there. It kind of irritated me, because I feel like that same girl that was in there using my same dryers could have been the one to do it. I wanted to bat the shit out of her, because my Friday was already about to start off rough with the fact that them folks at Hyundai wanted to give me problems. But anyway, we could turn this shit around and try to enjoy the rest of the Friday. Yeah, my neck is getting back right whatever. I'm switching up my diet and everything. So everything about to get right. The scale that moved, it went from, I think, so at the beginning of this month, it was like 232. Today, I'm 227.8. But it would have been even lower than that if I had kept, you know, going at the beginning of the month. But I fell off and got back on track. I've been on track since I've been on track since Sunday, I want to say. Because Monday, I was 230.2. So, to be 3 pounds less right now with my cycle on at the end of the week is a plus. So, I'm just gunning for the lose more and more, you know. I be working out every other day. I do my sit-up, my stomach workouts, and I do 10 push-ups every night. But I didn't do them last night, and I've been a little cramping a bit, excuse me, today. But yeah, and I've been fasting, y'all. I really only eat one meal a day. Other stuff be like snacks. Like, I really just been snacking today. I didn't finish the smoothie. I did finish my grilled cheese, but it had like a little small strawberry drink, and then I had some Ruffles. I didn't even eat the whole thing, but I had probably like almost half of the bag. So I just kind of like been snacking. So I'm going to this new restaurant. We're going to try this new restaurant that I've been seeing everybody advertising around the city. In Baton Rouge. I think it was some type of wing place, but I seen pictures and they had like big old cups of margaritas that looked good as fuck. And then they got my wings and stuff like that. So I'm like, you know what? I'm going to go and see what the vibes are about. It's like a 15-minute drive for me. And yeah, I'm going to take y'all with me. So we're going to go have some dinner, chill out, catch a vibe, turn this Friday around.
Y'all, I'm looking for the restaurant, but honestly, I don't see it. And it looks like they got a big old event over this way. Like, it's hella packed. I see people walking the streets. I'm dead ass looking for it, though, but I don't see it. I don't know. I know this is the address that's on their website, so I don't know, Pookies. This is the website. I really don't see it, though. And they got, like, hella cars. And then the police got the road blocked off. I don't know. So, I'm looking, trying to see if it's maybe down this road, or maybe I have to turn down the street or something. I don't see it, y'all. We might have to pick another restaurant. Electric. Unless this is the restaurant. I don't know. I kind of feel like that is the restaurant, but it's like hella packed. And the police has got the road blocked out. Well, oh, actually, no. It's a Market Madness. Like, this is where they are actually having an event or something. Bros. I'm trying not to hold up the traffic, but I'm really looking for the restaurant. See, y'all, they got some type of event over there. Is this it? No. Sorry, I'm going super duper slow. Markers Madness. I really don't see it, y'all. I think we're gonna have to settle on another restaurant. Another thing, I don't want to be caught down here on these streets too late and be stuck in traffic. I don't see it, though, y'all. I looked it up. I put the address in. I was looking like, I don't see a sign. I see the street you turn down, but that's actually the street that they have blocked off. And that street, yeah, they have that street blocked off by the police, dude. In that street, that's it. That's actually where they have an event that people are walking to. So you know what? We're gonna have to try that restaurant another time. I don't see it, honestly. I don't. I put the address in. I don't see the sign. I didn't
for them drinks. I ain't gonna even lie to y'all. Shit, I should have went to El Paso. El Paso, but it's 6 o'clock. I kind of want me a margarita. It's like KOK. I don't see the nothing. I really don't. I ain't lying to y'all. So I'm trying to think of another restaurant you can go to. I got in mind. It's like they having some type of, it gives you vibes of like a pop-up shop, but it's like down the entire street. Like no cap. Like the entire street. Like look. They like everywhere they can set up. They walk in the streets with their drinks. Everything. So I think I'ma just go to a restaurant that I know. Wings do sound good as fuck. I ain't gonna even lie. Wings and a good ass like margarita right now sound good to me. It sounds good for the soul. I'ma check in with y'all though. I'ma turn down one of these streets I know that they I'm thinking Chili's though, y'all. I feel like Chili's sounds really good right now. So I might go to them. They be having wings. I'm thinking. I'm gonna come back to y'all once I figure it out. Hey, child, my favorite restaurant. We at Chili's. Y'all should have known this while I was coming. So, I'm gonna put me some mayo on my burger and eat it. But I don't want to get copyrighted, so I'm gonna come back to y'all. Come to Chili's and I get the drinks, I get the on the rocks drinks. A period is on too. But I'm like hella tipsy. I just want like some good conversation. I keep fucking playing y'all. Let me tell y'all for real. So actually I got my ISBN and my barcode for my book, but I feel like I'm missing a bunch. I gotta format my book. I don't feel like doing it. Well, my book will probably be available on Amazon Kindle, though, without a doubt. Quick as anything. It's just me formatting it for prints. And, yeah, I got my different ways I want to market it, too. I just got to run my money up, okay? Bitch! I'm so tipsy. I can't lie to y'all. I'm, like, so tipsy. I feel so good. My cycle is on. It's doing me really, really well. Shout out to God. Shout out to me for taking care of myself in the process. Y'all, I want to show y'all my outfits that I picked up for the weekend today. But I'm going to talk to y'all while I'm on the way to the house. Y'all, today was good. It turned out to be good. I'm so glad I treated myself to dinner. To not let people control the finishing of my day. And even when I go to the house, I'm a vibe and chill out. Y'all, is anything going on today? I think it is tonight, but I ain't really here for that. Yeah, I'm going to a party tomorrow night. Am I taking y'all with me? I don't know. I might. My camera's about to die. I'm going to try to talk to y'all before it does. But, so, I'm just feeling good. I'm hella tipsy. Let me see what this bitch talking about. Don't play with me. I'm headed to the house. I'm so tipsy. And it's a waste of time. I'm not like one of them rowdy bitches. Like when I get tipsy, I don't get rowdy. I get horny. But I ain't even got nobody to fuck. And I don't got nobody to fuck because I'm stubborn. I'm picky. Only like certain things. I ain't finna fuck nobody broke. I just gotta know you got money. I don't know. I'm not the only one that thinks like this. I just feel like if I'm not broke, why would I fuck somebody that's broke? We on two different things. Plus, I'm trying to get rich. That's another thing. You don't know if you're trying to stay broke or get some money. I just know you broke. I know I'm trying to get rich, but I ain't broke. Y'all, tomorrow we vibing out, but before I even do anything, I have to go to a family member's viewing. And he was young, you know. I think they say he died with an asthma attack. Rest in peace, Scooter. May your soul rest on in peace. I pray for the family strength, you know, through things, because no matter what we're going through, we really cannot stand going through funerals. None of us want to lose family members here. I mean, if we want to be real, we don't. And I've been seeing a lot of people take a lot of losses. I'm one of them. I lost about 3 family members. Wasn't, like, close, but we knew each other. Like, we didn't go to every event, but we knew each other. And we've seen each other at events. I work with, you know, some people. It's just, it's been. You want me to cuss you out? But yeah, I do pray for healing. And that strength is what we all need when we're going through loss of family members. And So yeah, I do have to do that. I'm not going to take y'all with me because one thing about it, I don't appreciate nobody recording and taking pictures of deceased people at funerals, whatever. I don't do that. I don't like it. I don't support it. You know, you do as you please, but that's not something that I'm into. I don't like it. And I mean, no home.
It's training day.
Hey guys, welcome back to the channel.
I look cute. I did me a quick little ponytail, y'all, for the weekend. Put rubber bands on. It got rubber bands on and everything. I was supposed to be washing my hair. Y'all know I had told y'all I was going to wash my hair. I'm going to start taking this shit out here because, baby, look. I have to go. I was trying to wait on him to get out of the shower, but I need to go. I have to be slow. Anyway. But yeah, so. Well, I'm checking again with y'all when I get in the car, shit.
Girl, it's alright, baby. I'm just flat, look.
I hope it's cute, y'all, because it's giving. It feels like it's not.
These are supposed to be hanging. Ain't no fun if nothing, if you're loving alone. How does it feel to be useless? My shit. Oh no.
still remember those feelings again. Seems like it.
What's up, y'all? What's up? I'm finally in the car. And I'm headed to Mississippi for the rest of the day, child. We is headed out of town. It is Mother's Day weekend. It's Mother's Day weekend. Turn y'all, cause y'all know I'm leaving out of the apartment. As long as I can remember, I try to turn the camera, you know. Anyway, I whipped up me a quick little ponytail, y'all. I told y'all this is what I was gonna do. I think I told y'all. Or I thought about it. I don't know. I had to whip up something because I was not about to wash my hair. But when I come back to the house Sunday, I'm gonna wash it and twist it and everything. Well, I said this ain't nothing happen if I can remember. Okay, boom. So yeah. We headed to Mississippi, y'all. We got a few things to do. I have to go to this viewing that I'm actually gonna probably be a little late for. Not really late. I think it's 4 hours, so I just have to get to Mississippi, and I think my mom is gonna, I think she's gonna go with me. I don't know. But yeah. Yeah, y'all, happy Saturday. It is 's Day weekend. I hope that you guys have gotten your mother something. Mother guardian. If you could afford it, you know, looked out for some other people that probably looked out for you before, that some other, or that you probably looked at as a mother, you know, whatever your situation is. I just have a prayer that you guys enjoy the rest of the weekend, you know, because that's what I'm finna do. I'm not gonna say I'm gonna try to do or this, that, and the third. I'm about to do that. So, yeah. So this weekend, which is today is Saturday. So today we are, today we are headed to a viewing before we even do anything. And then gonna kind of chill out, you know, vibe out, probably make me a daiquiri or anything, go buy one, whatever the case may be. Get some more stuff I know for a fact for Mother's Day. That enjoy. Oh, tonight I have a party to go to. I might bring y'all in the party with me. I might not, y'all. I don't know. Y'all, it's just I be trying to vibe out. But I might bring y'all with me, you know. Oh, Jesus, it's hot. Look at this girl. You know that's how my shoes is? You're cuter. Them how my shoes are. What I'm wearing to that party. Alright. She must be looking for her man or something. Y'all, she got on this short dress. Them girls say, girls or whatever they are, said, what you got on, a shirt or something? It's yours here. This mine's right here. Y'all, just got some food from one of these local, the local restaurant. Man, oh, mom, you got more. Oh, you got a wrench in them. I gotta have that wrench. Alright, y'all. This is a fruit punch. I did good with my little smoothie though, y'all. Look, this is all I got left. I'm thinking about saving this part for tomorrow. No, they just be on drugs.
I treat you right for them 12 hours, man. You ain't no way you not want to do it.
What's
these.
If I understand everything you're doing. Hey, what's up?
Happy Mother's Day! I'll be gone.
Yeah, I couldn't. I don't know what's going on. I just stretched my dress out. It ain't supposed to stretch like that. The space supposed to be on my side, honey. But yeah. What's up, y'all? It's the next day, y'all. It's the next day after Mother's Day. I look heat, do I? To y'all, doesn't matter. This is my real hair. I had washed it last night. I came in. Y'all had made it kind of late. So when I came in, I kind of did my little stuff I usually would do on Sundays. But I just really cleaned myself up, exfoliated my skin, washed my hair. Put these little twists in. I gotta start recording. Like, I should have recorded. I mean, I should have ended the vlog last night after I did my hair, so y'all could really see how pretty my plaits be. Okay, I'm back. I was deleting some memory off my memory card. Kind of text message that I just get. Yeah, I've been going shoe fucking crazy, but it's because I have clothes that never have been worn. I stepped on the scale. I really hope and pray it's because of my bloatness that the scale has picked up like that. It's like 231. I had got down to 227 last Friday. Today is Monday. But Saturday it picked up. It was 228. I think I went, because I went to Chili's that Friday. So today I stepped on there this morning. It was like 231.4 or 8. Write that down. So hopefully when my cycle goes off that it goes back down. Because usually it's like when my cycle is on, that's why I be so shocked when the scale actually goes down. But it's like when my cycle is on, the scale usually goes like it shoots up like 3 or 4 pounds. So hopefully when my cycle goes off, it actually goes down. But I'm going to end the vlog, y'all. I am prepping for another vlog now. Honestly, I don't know if I'm filming this weekend. I don't have any plans, and I don't know if any events going on. And so I don't know if I'm filming this weekend, but I have been filming, y'all, like ongoing. I want to get some things situated for my book because I've been marketing, but I'm now at the phases of having to format the book and trying to make sure I'm following all the proper steps before putting it out there because I have to put it on certain platforms. And then I plan to actually order me some prints just in case, like, I want to sell them on the street. Not that many, but I'm going to order some just for a preview of my book to sell. But also, it's just me getting it completed, and I feel like I should take this weekend and do that because I have my ISBNs and I have my barcode. So it's like, what's the point? Like, what am I, everything, the ball is in my court basically. So I have to do that, and I'm probably going to be doing that every day. Right now, today, I'm not doing it today. I'm just basically looking at some more steps I might need to consider or take or follow. So that's what I was doing in my phone. So yeah, it's just making sure that everything's done and complete for the book. So I'm going to start on that. Do that this week, work on formatting and just whatever other steps that I need to take, so I can put my book out. But good news is that everything should be set up to where it's, could be put out. You know what I'm saying? So, blah, blah, blah. But anyway, so I'm just basically gearing up for the week. I then came home and ate some more food, so I'm feeling very energized, way better than what I was feeling earlier. And, I'm just going to gear up, get my fruits and vegetables, clean up a little bit more because I didn't really clean up. And I'm going to bed early tonight, hopefully no later than 8 or 9 o'clock because your girl was feeling extremely bad today from the weekend, okay? Did not get out of my rest. But anyway, so I will check back in with y'all in the next video. Make sure y'all like, comment, and subscribe. And stay tuned because my book is coming. I love y'all. See y'all next video.